One of the most controversial topics to discuss in the gaming community is Nintendo going third party. Now, usually if you mention anything about Nintendo going third party or their system selling like crap, you'll be greeted by tons of sarcastic fans saying, "Oh no, Nintendo's doomed," even though they're not funny. But not only that, but it also shows their ignorance to the gaming market. And what do I mean? Well, take a look at the whole thing happening with the Wii U. Now, while the 3DS has sold less than its predecessor, the Nintendo DS, the Wii U has just been a train wreck. It sold like crap, with the Xbox One and PS4 outselling it. And not only that, but they've outsold it in a short period of time compared to how long the Wii U has been on the market. I mean, the Wii U had an extra year head start, and yet it sold like crap, being brushed aside by many as a quick stopgap system until the real next-gen systems came out. But to make matters worse for Nintendo, their system has not only suffered from a severe lack of third party, with even third parties who supported them in some of the tougher times for Nintendo, such as the GameCube era, pulling out, but the Wii U has also suffered from another problem. It's been the worst selling Nintendo system yet. Nearly every third party game is non-existent on the Wii U, and in fact, there are even several videos showing this problem, from one video showing a whole montage of games that just aren't on the Wii U, to another video showing, like, actually somebody made a list of 150 games and counting that are on the PS3, the 360, but not the Wii U. That's right, they're on last-gen systems, but not the Wii U. Speaking of third party, even the third parties that supported Nintendo during the Wii U days already have dumped them. Call of Duty Advanced Warfare from Activision is not on the Wii U, along with Destiny from the same company, while Ubisoft announced that Watch Dogs was going to be their last mature title for the Wii U. This is not a good thing, as this means many Wii U gamers are going to be disappointed when they cannot find their newest games, and will have to get the game on another system. This literally leaves the Wii U as a Nintendo game-only system. It's impossible if you're a gamer to only play your games on the Wii U. And unless you only play Nintendo games with the Nintendo logo on them, or of course third-party games that fit in the Nintendo mold like the Sonic series or the Mega Man series, you're not going to have a lot of games to play on the Wii U. And even then, if you're one of those people who only plays Nintendo-branded games and character platformers, here's the thing. You're as much of a gamer as those people who only buy, like, let's just say, a gaming system to play Call of Duty, Madden, and literally that's it. Or those people who bought a PS2 to literally only play Madden and Grand Theft Auto. And since the Wii U lacks in literally every area, people have to say it's the best system ever with the same parroted phrase. The games. The games. The games. Every time I see somebody hyping the Wii U up on some website, it's always for the same reason. It has Mario Kart 8. It has Splatoon. It has Mario. It has Mario. It has Mario. It has Zelda. That is the one battle cry I see with people online. But yet, many people aren't going to spend $300 on a system that can't do anything but play a handful of games. I mean, sure, the Xbox One and PS4 might be outdated, when compared to a more expensive PC, that is. But then you have the Wii U, and it uses, for a similar price point, PowerPC G3 processors, straight out of a 90s Macintosh, and a low-end GPU. It's not high-end whatsoever. And yet, here's the thing, it has no games. So you've got a low-end piece of hardware with no games, that's about $300, and many people besides the Nintendo faithful aren't going to shell out that much for it. But then again, the Nintendo faithful will happily buy any toy of their favorite character, right? Even if it's not the best figure, even if it's just a static figure, which stands on a base that they can use for DLC in some games, I guess. But outside that Nintendo faithful audience, it's a hard sell to convince them to buy a Wii U over, say, an Xbox One, a PS4, or a nice PC for, I don't know, several hundred dollars, maybe $1,000, maybe more, depending on how much you want to do with that computer. So here's the thing. If Nintendo's games are so good that everybody has to praise them, what would hurt putting them on a non-Nintendo system? I mean, considering how games are the only thing people talk about with the Wii U, with even Nintendo's first-party games making use of the gamepad by either using it as a great big horn button or just blacking the screen out like with Donkey Kong. And the off-TV thing? Well, the PS4 and Xbox One can do it with hardware that can actually be used standalone. The PS4 having it with the Vita, and the same feature coming soon to the Xbox One, which will work with any Windows 10 computer. And of course, there's also some demand for games to come on the Wii U to other systems. I mean, just take a look at Sonic Lost World, Sonic Colors, and Bayonetta 2. Those games got some good reception from some people, and of course they were published by Nintendo, or at least Nintendo exclusive because of an exclusivity deal. But yet, unlike when an Xbox One or a PS4 game comes to the PC, people don't praise or beg for that. Instead, if it's with Nintendo, they'll start complaining and say, "You're just salty, because after all, the gaming industry revolves around playground rules, right?" I mean, I'm not talking about the indie game scene, I'm talking about the big professional game scene. And if people are praising the games aspect of the Wii U so much, I thought it's because, like, people care about games and not because of what logo they have on their console, right? Because considering how much Nintendo struggles to make a system worth buying, it should be asked, what is so wrong with Nintendo becoming third party? Because honestly, at this point, considering how badly they're doing making a console, I think they might as well become third party at this point, because nobody should have to spend $300 on a system just to play a handful of games. Either that, or they'll actually have to make a system that's worth buying to anybody who doesn't go around in public wearing that Zelda or Pokemon t-shirt with a 3DS in their hand and saying, "Hey dude, you wanna Pokemon battle me? Also, my Animal Crossing town is sick because it lets me have my waifu." So, that's all that really needs to be said. Thanks for watching and subscribe for more.